Welcome back to Upfront. A state lawmaker is sharing his deeply personal story in hopes of stopping the surge of heroin abuse in Wisconsin. State Representative John Nygren's daughter is an addict. She's currently in the Marinette County Jail. Her father is taking part in a public awareness campaign on heroin. He's also proposed a series of bills he hopes will help. And State Representative John Nygren joins us now on Upfront. Representative, good to have you back on the program.
It's good to be here again.
It's a tough subject to talk about, but put it in personal terms for our audience. What has this heroin problem meant for you and your family?
Well, I mean, the hopes and dreams of a child when you have them never is an addiction part of that right. Hope and that part of that dream. But, you know, from a smart, pretty girl with a lot of hopes for the future, getting to a point where she doesn't graduate from high school, to, you know, finding her overdosed on the floor with a needle still in her arm, purple, struggling to breathe, to seeing her, you know, wearing jail-issued orange. You know, all those different things are not what any parent wants for their kids. The good news in her situation is she's still alive. She survived the overdose. A lot of parents out there don't have that advantage that we have for a second chance.
That's an important point, because your daughter Cassie is a story, but this story has been repeated in many parts of the state. I mean, you live in Marinette. That's not a huge metropolitan area. This is not just a big city issue.
When we first learned of this problem for Cassie about 4 years ago, we thought it was unique to Marinette for whatever reason. You know, we're a community that seems to be a hotbed for it. But what we found out is, first of all, some of the reasons behind the Marinette problem. We had a doctor selling OxyContin prescriptions. We have the Michigan border, which is the Michigan side is not as anywhere near as strict on drug dealing penalties as we are. So that kind of magnified the problem. And then once the OxyContin dried up, and that's where 90-95% of the addiction started, not only in Marinette but statewide, it went to heroin. So we thought we were unique, but as I've come public with this and started to propose legislation, we've heard from people all over the state, we've heard from leaders all over the state on how big of a problem this is, and it's not just an inner city Milwaukee problem, it's a statewide problem.
Let's talk a little bit about your legislation. One of the things provides some immunity for people who call 911 to report an overdose or take somebody to the emergency room. Why is that so important?
Well, you'll read the stories in the newspaper, hear them on the radio, TV, about somebody that was found dead from an overdose.
Your daughter could have been that person. Wasn't there somebody in the house with her who left?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, her mom went home to close the windows because of a storm that was approaching, and found the friends, went into the front door. The friends were running out the door at the same time as she found Cassie and called me. But why it's important is we hear these stories over and over again. Most of the time, they're not alone when they use the drug. They're with somebody else. And the law, as it sits right now, they're afraid to call because they're afraid of a conviction for possession. So, I mean, I think there was a story here in Milwaukee a few years ago, a young girl was dumped in a snowbank. We need to change that culture. You know, first of all, we need to put a stop to the drug abuse, but we need to change the culture within that drug abuse culture now that says, you know, it's all about me. I don't care if my friend dies. So picking up the phone, making that call to save a life, you under this proposal, you would get immunity for simple possession. If you're a dealer, no. Yeah. But simple possession, yes.
There's also an ID component to this. Why is that necessary?
There is. Brown County Drug Task Force came forward with this issue. One of the problems they found is at the pharmacy. As I said, this starts with prescription drugs in almost every
case.
Opiates, yep. And unfortunately today, there's a lot of falsification of prescriptions going to the pharmacy. And right now, I could go into the pharmacy and pick up my Boucher's prescription as long as I pay for it. And that makes it more difficult for them to be able to track where the drugs are going and to be able to fight the crime of drug abuse. So we're going to require an ID. You still be able to pick up your husband, wife's prescription. You're just going to have to prove who you are, and they're going to write it down.
I want to bring this full circle. What are your hopes for your daughter at this point?
Hey, I hope she still has that future that we all dream for. The potential is still there. She survived the overdose. So I think it's going to be a struggle for her for the rest of her life. Any addict, it's a day-to-day struggle, but she still has the opportunity to be able to turn her life around and be a happy, successful person.
Representative John Nygren, the Republican from Marinette, thanks for sharing your story today.
Thank you. We appreciate it.
You bet. Next, the latest Democrat to enter the race for Congressman Paul Ryan's seat. I'll be talking with candidate Rob Zerban next. But first, here's the WIS Politics Week Ahead.
The State Assembly will be back in session on Tuesday to consider drunken driving bills and bills from the Speaker's Mental Health Task Force.